Hey guys, it's exercise time, 50 minutes of fun exercise. So now it's 8:45, we should stop at 9:35. Okay, so yes, these 2 weeks, days, I think slightly there's some improvement. I know there's still the bulge and all this, you know, truffle shuffle belly, but it's definitely getting there. I've been losing some weight. So this week, yes, there's at least about a kg near there that I've lost. So yes, things are looking up. Now with also my, you know, trying to just track, that I realized that, okay, so far I've been exercising and keeping to the heart rate for at least half an hour. Obviously, I've been doing 50 minutes every day. So hope you guys also improve your health, and please take care, eat healthy, and do exercise or get some kind of workout, okay? So don't be too sedentary like I am back in the past, like every day just sitting down and very bad for your health, okay? And yeah, like I said, for me, the weight I need to lose because of my back problem, I have slipped this, so no choice. I'd rather be big and fat, seriously, I really do. But I have no choice. So because the weight directly impacts my health, and I don't have the best of genes, and also, you know, my family medical history, so that's why I had to do this. Anyway, let's get going. 15 minutes of exercise again. Hello, hi guys, everyone. Whoever is viewing now, thanks for your encouragement, your love, your likes, and your support to me. Hope I in turn encourage you guys also to take care of your health. I'm glad that I met some friends online again as well, some new friends who were sharing with me. They are from a medical profession. So yeah, you know, great. Sharing me about some medical insights into diabetes and stuff like that. So I was sharing about my own journey as well in this. Okay, so, oh my god. Like the other day, right? I think was it yesterday? We broke this. I mean, I broke this while exercising, so yeah, now it's even shorter, so it's a bit hard, a lot of resistance, so I'm still trying to season this. It's not easy. Oh, thank you so much for the likes, thank you, domo arigato gozaimasu. Oh, I learned a few more thank yous, now I remember. Oh shit, the Tamil one is tough. Miki Nandri, I think that's Tamil for thank you. Miki or Maki? Maki Nandri. That's thank you for in Tamil, I think. Hello, 感謝, 謝謝. Terima kasih, kopungkap, selamat, 感謝합니다, domo arigato gozaimasu, grazie. So that's Spanish, am I wrong? Grazie, obrigada, of course, danke schön. Still thinking, wait, I learned the other two, Italian and Spanish and French. French is merci beaucoup, yes. Italian is grazie, I think. Right? And gracias. Oh, muchas gracias, that's Spanish. Yay! Added more language to say thank you just now. So that's good. Again, hello, hi guys, whoever's viewing. Saturday night, hope you guys are partying, having fun, or like me, maybe going to the gym. Going to exercise, eating healthy, I hope. Try to lower your sugar level, you know. Too much sugar is just not good. You don't want to get into diabetes. Seriously. So if you look at my title, Day 88, right? Yes, my first Chinese single, 动心不动情. I know it's very lame kind of title, but it's meant to be like that. It's like kind of 80s kind of, a tribute to the 80s kind of feel. Where the title sometimes very lame. So it's my EP, my singles, three songs. It's in Spotify now, Deezer. It didn't manage to go into iTunes and Apple Music because they don't allow Chinese to upload music upload apparently. I don't know why. I'm still trying to figure out how to the Chinese market go into Apple Music. But I'm still waiting for the next few, 1 or 2 weeks. It will be going into KKBOX, QQ Music and other Tencent. And many other Chinese streaming services, maybe Kugou as well, I think. So let's see how. But if you guys are interested, keep going and search 动心不动情. Basically, it's under my Chinese name, Ling Zili. So I'm like keeping separate from my English album electronic music, which is Tilip. Because I feel It's a different market, let's put it this way. I think different market. Yeah. But let's see how, if this work out, because I'm using a music service, it doesn't charge me a single cent. They only take 15% cut if there is any profit. If lah, I don't think so mine did. Anyway, mine is just really purely for fun. And the artist or musician get to keep 85% of the, you know, any profit if there is lah from streaming and if from people listening to it. So if you want to help me or support, go and search that song. In currently it's in Spotify and Deezer. YouTube Music, they haven't got it in yet. But my English album, the EP album, Orgasmic, is in all the major streaming services, including Apple Music. So go and check it out. Again, thank you. Hello. Thanks for whoever is watching this. Thank you so much. Domodikato gazamas. Kamsangnida. Sisye, toze. Kamsia. Selamat. Kopungkap. Muchas gracias. Grazie. Mike Nandri, that's Tamil, if I'm wrong, but thank you. Obrigada, Dankeschön. What else? Ah, trying to keep remembering how to say all the different language. Thank you. Merci beaucoup, that's in French. That's it, I guess. Okay, so how's your Saturday? Actually, today I was supposed to go to the daily. Nest daily meetup. So as you guys know, last week he came to Singapore, set up his company here, and will be basing his roots, I guess, here, basing his of his company work here. So actually, I wanted to go, but I realized it was at 4 p.m. I thought it was 5 p.m. So I thought it was too late. And here in the north of Singapore, it felt like it's going to rain. Oh, thank you so much for the likes. Thank you. Arigatou gozaimasu. Kamsahamnida. Sisi. Thanks for the luck. So, I thought they're going to be raining soon, so it might be cancelled or what, so I didn't go down. But yeah, I've seen that the post from Nest Daily, N-A-S, Nest Daily, and he did a meetup at the Botanical Gardens. It seems huge, like thousands of people there, I think. So great. I mean, I'm glad that, you know, notable influencers or celebrity, foreign talents, I would say, basing in Singapore, they help to rise the visibility but also hopefully rise the quality of our works here coming from Singapore, and you know, influence everyone around as well. It's a holistic thing, so you can't just think that, oh, now there is a competition. I mean, competition is going to be everywhere, especially when it comes to social media. It's going to be from everywhere. But if they're based in Singapore, you know, they'll be paying taxes, in a way it's good for our economy as well. And working out from Singapore, it proves that, you know, Singapore might be that good destination. Has a certain level of safety for businesses. So that's a good thing, seriously. I really see it as a positive thing. A lot of people say that yes, because doing business in Singapore is cheaper. Maybe the taxes are not so bad. And of course, generally the environment, there's no like chaos or uprising or political problem, corruption, and many others, like even natural catastrophe disasters. Singapore is free of all those, or very little of all those issues and security and stuff like that. No doubt it's not one of the expensive cities in the world, there's no doubt, but that's because of our small scarcity in land, and hence it drives up our property prices and our car prices. And if you use that as a gauge to compare to other countries, yes, it is the most expensive. But apparently, our local food, like hawker center, food center, is actually one of the cheaper ones around the region. Okay, don't say Malaysia or Indonesia, they have even more affordable food, that's for sure. I love them, trust me. I love Malaysian food. I didn't go to Indonesia much to comment. But at least in terms of developed nation, and so our local food actually one of the cheaper options, but still prices are always rising. Like yesterday, in fact this weekend, Singapore hold a namesake, I would say, of Shi Ling Jie in Turf City, Turf Club in Singapore, Kranji area. It's more like it uses the name of Shi Ling, so frankly speaking, I've been to Shi Ling before, and It's not like that. You know, the whole feel and the pricing is ridiculously high. So this is Singapore for you, okay? Food that is more well packaged, has a branding, has a marketing, it's gonna cost a lot more. Easily cost 4 to 5 times more than in Taiwan itself, in Shilin. And the food, I feel not like 70-80% of them are authentic. It feels like it's more local version of the Taiwanese food. So, well, I do wish that my Taiwanese friend, maybe they bring authentic Taiwan food into Singapore or cook here and stuff like that. So I was like looking for guan cai ban, seriously. Like, it's a bread that they carve up. Think of it like a bread soup, you know? But it's made of pieces of bread and inside has the soup itself, but has gravy and stuff. And it's very tasty. I had it in other restaurants before in the past, but I know guan cai ban has a lot of carbs inside, so if I were to buy it, it's just to sample it, and the remaining of it, leave it to my friends to eat, who are more healthier than me, so they can take the high carbs, high carbohydrates in those kind of food. And like mee sua, oh I love mee sua, oh should I say ou jian, oyster mee sua, you know? And also the ou jian, which is oyster omelette, sorry. So the one in Taiwan is more chewy, more like sticky, I think. In Singapore, it's more dry, almost like a biscuit kind of thing. Not biscuit, but dry, crispy, that's cui. So Singapore version is different. So Taiwanese version is also nice in its own way. And I doubt they will have zhu xue gao, right? The pig's blood, they made into a cake or something, it's like hardened. And I see that in Shilin. Okay, that unfortunately is not my cup. It's not my kind of taste that I like. I don't really like blood. I mean, I'm okay to see blood, I don't faint, but to eat it, suppose we go for your health, right? You know, like if you lack of iron, you eat the blood, you know, pig's blood in soup and stuff. It helps to rejuvenate, I think, the iron in your blood or something. So, but no, just a bit gross for me. But you know, I'm sure Taiwanese friend who's looking at this, maybe will love your zhu xue gao, your pig's blood kind of like, you know, food. Anyway, so how have you guys been this afternoon? Any new adventures? I hope you guys can share in the comments and stuff like that. For me, whole day again, I'm just clearing some stuff from my email, trying to learn some more things from my online media, like online businesses, and also, I don't know, generally I think I'm a bit lethargic today, I don't know, a bit lazy for some reason. I almost wanted to sleep just now before the exercise. But I just feel like, my energy a bit low today, I don't know why, I'm not sure is it because of the rain. It's been raining in the morning and then later in the afternoon. So it feels very cooling, I think. Maybe that changes my mood sometimes. Again, you know, your mood can change from day to day. Doesn't mean that I start this exercise, it means, oh, I'll be like 100% energy all the time. There's ups and downs, of course, that's for sure. Now, for lunch, I basically heat up my remaining part of Sarawak laksa paste that I made into a broth, and I added things like sesame sauce, and some brown rice, some just like two tablespoon scoop or something, just to bulk up. And there's tofu inside, it's just tau guan, so beancurd, some kind of beancurd inside. I put in beef, minced beef, and I did grill my saba fish. So just grilled it with butter. So it's like, oh, so nice. That's really nice. Saba fish just grilled is just great, seriously. The fish, the flesh itself is very juicy actually. Ooh. So it goes very well with my dad laksa stew, I would say. Like a stew. Because I thicken it, put in some, what did I put? Just put in more condiments, I guess. And veggie, yes, I put some peas and corn. And that's it, that's my lunch. I did end it with a bit of a sweet dessert, so-called, which is the naturally sweetened by goji berry and raisins. The keto-friendly cake and bread that I made a few days ago. So yes, I slowly eat it over the whole week. As I put it in the fridge, it's fine, it doesn't turn bad. And it's nice. what I did was, I did put a piece of like one piece of dark chocolate. So it's like has some sweetness to it. So I put a piece of dark chocolate and heat it up about 30 to 1 minute in the microwave. And oh my god, my bread and the cake turned out to be so moist and still soft. So it was like, great. I found the recipe at last. I did it myself, experimented, and did this cake and bread that works. So yeah, moving forward, you know, I'll still keep experimenting, try out different flavor profile, different ingredients to get different kind of pastry or cakes that hopefully is as keto friendly as possible. Low carb and definitely hopefully no gluten. Now, the other day I see my doctor, right? So I was telling her I've been baking and have been using whipping cream. So whipping cream and milk, such thing has kind of actually high carb. So she suggested to me maybe I should try changing it to yogurt. So I might try that. So tomorrow when I go for my grocery shopping, I'm gonna buy yogurt and see how does yogurt react to the ingredients for making keto friendly bread and cakes. So it has to be the unsweetened yogurt, of course. Greek yogurt, I guess. But most yogurt I saw in the supermarket is always flavored. It's like vanilla or some kind of fruity flavor. So I don't know, there might be still some kind of sugar inside. So I'm trying to get unsweetened. I did buy before, but I stopped for a while because I often don't finish it and end up it turned bad very quickly. It's sour, you know? Yogurt is sour, but it turned bad. You can see the water leaking out. It's like, bleh. So it's not easy. It's like, once you open it up, you better use it within a few days. Even in the fridge, it does turn bad. So that's something that I have to work with. So yogurt, so yeah. So instead of whipping cream to thicken my broth, or thicken the kind of soup or something, I might have to find like yogurt as a substitute. I'm not sure if you'll come up with the same kind of texture. Anyway, it's worth a try. So that's the fun about cooking and baking. Because you learn and experiment with different ingredients and see what works and change the flavor profile of your, you know, product. So far, okay. The song I'm cycling to is about 15 to 17 kilometers per hour, still low tempo. But my heart rate monitor says I am. Let me see, why is it not showing now? Okay, I think it turned off. Yeah, it turned off. Just now I did turn it on. It turned off the heart rate. Oh, okay. Got to let it register again. Ah, what's going on? Anyway. Okay, what time do I start? Oh, yeah. I'm going to finish at 9:35. Okay. It keeps saying wear tighter. My God, it's really so tight. Look at that. My flesh really eating into... Sorry, the straps really eating into my flesh. Okay. Anyway, so, and I have burned so far 29,314 calories, traveled 919 kilometers in the past 88 days. So that's good. You know, keep on going, guys. Let's go, let's go. Oh, Kemu, Kemu, Kemu. So just now, I was chatting with someone from US. He said hi, chat with me that he's a nurse and that he deals with diabetes in children. So I was sharing also my point of view and how I decided to change and my mindset and my determination. So he was saying that, oh, how he wished that I could be there to help share my experience with his patients. So I'm saying, I'm more than glad to do that, but unfortunately, we are so far apart, different nation. So, and it's not the first time someone was asking me to share my experience. Because the other day when I was at Active SG at the gym and the body composition measurement, that the coaches there were sharing my story of how I was like, you know, on this health journey and what made me change. And they say, yeah, in the future, if there's a chance, if there's a talk, would I like to share my experience with other patients or other people? So I say, of course. I mean, I'm honored to. I'm not a trained professional, but I'm just sharing my own experience and what made me change and stuff like that. And more importantly is the consistency and tracking your progress. I always say that, track your progress. If you don't track your progress, you won't know whatever diet plan or exercise you're doing, is it working or not? You have to keep doing it for months and years, okay? Not like a few weeks and you give up. Not like a few months and say, forget it, let's try something else. You'll be inconsistent. Then you won't know what works or what do or what do not work. Again, hello. Thanks whoever. I can't see, the text is a bit small, far away from me. Thanks for the love, the likes, comment and the encouragement. Thank you so much. Arigato gozaimasu. Honto arigato. Kamsahamnida. Sisiye. Kamsia. Tote. Selamat. Terima kasih. Kepungkap. Merci. Buku. Dankeschön. Obrigada. Grazie. Muchas gracias. Minke. Manke or minke. Minke nanri. Which is Tamil for thank you. I think I got it wrong the first word. I need to go revise it. So, let's go. Hey! Kampate! Otsukare sama! Yes! Hello, Bible's Ring. Hi. Thanks for the interest. Thanks for the like, the comment, the heart, the encouragement. Hope I can encourage you guys to keep fit as well. Thank you. Arigato gozaimasu. Kamsahamnida. Sisiye. Tote. Kamsia. Terima kasih. Selamat. Kepungkap. Hyper Potions. The song, Time Trials. Let's go. Whoa. Cycling at about 19 to 20 kilometers now with this tempo. Woo! Let's go. Don't give up. Like when I was trying to create my own music, Chinese music, and previous year, I was releasing my EP album of electronic music. So many times I feel, the software is not easy to use. Or like, music, why I couldn't get what I want? I didn't give up. I keep trying. So many strange songs that I created. But still eventually, I just want to complete it. I know it's not my best work, I feel. Maybe some are okay, pretty good, my own opinion. But the rest are like, something that I could still accept, but I know with better knowledge in the future, I can hopefully create even better songs and electronic music to share with everyone. Again, doing this not for the money's sake, for learning and to understand how the whole process of creation, music to distribution and maybe even marketing it, as in to share with people so that people know about the songs I create. Yes, it does take my own pocket money to do it. A lot of things in life needs money. But this new service that I have is free, so I don't know how was their plan actually. But anyway, Rock Note. R-O-U-T-E-N-O-T-E. Rock Note is a music distributor. And it's free. We just sign up, upload a song, artwork, fill up the details, and within about a week, your music is up in the streaming services. I mean, anyone can do that, seriously. I know, yes, there's millions and millions of people doing that. Okay, I don't say millions, but tens and hundreds of thousands of people, I guess, of artists. But only the good ones, of course, will surface. Hopefully, through this experience, I will try to improve my music creation, and hopefully, who knows, one day, more people know about it, and increase my fan base, so to speak. But me exercising in a way is also a way to show people, if you want, if you're determined to do it, you can. You're just going to find a way out. You're going to learn new things. just like the articles I've been sharing today, I think, about how AI, automation, they really replace people who are stocking like supermarket in Walmart. And Amazon's really doing a lot of that. And so, slowly it will trickle down from all these big companies to the smaller companies and to restaurants that you'll see in super, in malls and stuff. You will see a lot of robotics and automation going on. Even sushi, you know, Japanese restaurant, they're really doing that a lot. So you just got to upgrade. You got to think of new skills to learn, to so you don't get, you know, taotai, right? To be replaced by all this automation and robotics in life. It's going to come whether you like it or not, seriously. Because at the end of the day, automation and robotics for business owner, it saves money and increase efficiency. You know, I know some services people will say they rather see a human being. But guess what? Someday very soon, if robot becomes as near as humanoid, you know, crossing the uncanny valley kind of zone, and they look and feel and think like a human, you know, robots will be just our next replacement of human workers. So don't think it's far-fetched or too far away a dream. It is happening already. So get cranking, okay? Get thinking about your future career or advancement. Because once they get some automation or AI started with software, they could have replaced you, you know? If your job is related to it, that they can be replaced. If you think about it. A lot of people think, it won't happen. Or that, they want the human element. Is it true? Sometimes without human element, that may be fine for the business owner or company. So don't be surprised. A lot of old trades, more traditional work, especially the labor ones, that needs human labor, can be easily replaced by robotics. Let's go, let's go. Gesuno Kiwame Otome. This band. I still don't know the title of this song. It's in Japanese. I'll have to go online and translate, I guess, to understand what it means. Let's go, let's go. Whew. About coming to half an hour. Another 20 more minutes. After day 90, which is 2 more days time, I shall crank up my resistance. Maybe it's really up or no. To 7 out of 8. Again, my doctor did tell me, and I can start increasing resistance and do strength training, some kind of anaerobic muscle building exercises. So next week, in fact this week actually, this coming week, I shall go to Woodlands gym and try to approach that guy, the strength training coach, Boon. His name is called Boon, B-O-N. And yeah, get some program going to learn what kind of exercise I should do at the gym maybe, or at home if I can, because then I can record live and show you guys what I'm doing. Even at the gym I did record lah, but a bit more not convenient because I can't play my music that I like and talk to you guys freely. Because there'll be other people around, right? So it can't be a nuisance. Let's go, let's go. Oops. It's still very tight, this one. So it springs back very fast. I'm still trying to season it by pulling it as much as I can. Oh, another song, right? The same band again. Gesuno Kiwame Otome. Kiwami Otome. In Wikipedia, it translates this band as girl at the height of rudeness. It's like, what? Girl at the height of rudeness? So that girl is very rude. The most rude that she can be. I can't understand why, but the lead singer is a guy. One of the ladies, she's a keyboardist, I think. The drum, the percussion, I think is a guy. Of course, the bassist is that famous guy. Forgot his name. But he's Wade, I think. Is it Wade? don't remember listening to about it. So because he appeared in last season of Terrace House, which I did watch a few seasons. So I didn't watch from the first season. But the last season, which is also the last episode the last season at that place in... Oh, I can't even pronounce the name of it. But basically not too far from Tokyo, maybe about an hour or two drive from Tokyo apparently. So that place is in like a forest or something like that. And so in the last few episodes, the bassist from this music band joined. But sadly, in the end, he didn't get the love of his life. Or I don't say his life, but he approached the girl who was a model, rejected him. So, too bad. Some say because he's more pudgy, you know, like he's fat or big. He's like just cubby, right? It's not fat, seriously. I mean, not your model look, but too bad. He made her like really happy, bringing her to places and being so romantic and caring. But I guess she can't see past his physical self or something. And he's talented. I mean, he's the bassist for this famous band in Japan. So in a way, he's like a celebrity of sort. So this time, I'm quite surprised. In fact, the Terrace House commenters inside, who is viewing and commenting on the show, right, was also surprised that, oh my god, a celebrity actually decided to join this. Because so far, everyone in Terrace House has been like common people. You know, not like super famous or what, like some celebrity. I don't know, I didn't watch the first few seasons, maybe they have. Yes, there were professionals, like pro sports kind of like people, you know, professional sports. People in skiing, I think. Skiing, skateboarders, stuff like that. Who's like going to join the Olympics, stuff like that, you know. Hockey player, oh yeah, I remember the hockey player. Was it last season? She's like really good. She's like very tomboyish-like, but you know, in the end, she hooked up with the Caucasian guy who's Japanese, but you know, he's like Caucasian, so yeah. It's an interesting pair though. Anyway, so check it out, Terrace House, if you have not watched it before. Yeah, you can literally binge watch it for like 2-3 days. Because each episode, I think, is about an hour-ish long. So you see how it's like a so-called reality TV show, Big Brother style. Six people, you know, come together, three guys, three girls, and how they interact and stuff like that. So it's interesting because you can kind of see the Japanese culture as well, understand how they react to each other, the kind of things that go on. I mean, they too gossip as well, they also say things, and the way that they interact with each other, I thought that's interesting. For me, it's more like a culture exchange. Yeah, seriously, it's like a culture exchange program. Maybe they should open up Terrace House to other Asian countries, be it in the native country itself, or invite other people to come. But then they'll get to translate, because it's meant for Japanese, predominantly like Japanese audience. There'll be a lot of subtitling going on, I guess. And they need to cross a language barrier, unless everyone speaks English or something. Or they're overseas, they must be invited to Terrace House and speak Japanese, I guess. Anyway, so much for Terrace House. There's still other interesting show in Netflix. But again, I do get caught up in Netflix too much sometimes. Forget about my main job and work. So yeah, be careful. Okay, don't binge watch and forget about the time. Seriously, you can binge watch like the whole weekend away, man. So a bit scary. Because it's so interesting. Some stories are really interesting, the documentaries as well. Alright, this song! I Smile by Kirk Franklin. I like this song. Although it's a gospel kind of song, but today's a new day. But it's a very optimistic song. There is the sunshine. It's in my whole night. Today's a new day. Hey, hey, hey. Where are my blue skies? Alright. I almost gave up, but I can't remember. I can't explain. Fell from heavens like a shower. When I think I'm ready, then I'm gonna leave and this is over. Smile. than another even though I smile. It's quite high in the key. I can't sing that level. I smile. When you smile, so smile. Alright, 15 more minutes left. 2 days, a new day. So where is my sunshine? Things that feel so cold night. Today's a new day. So where are my blue skies? So alright, I cannot help but I can work. I can explain. Fell from heaven like a shower. Smile, I smile. Even you hurt, still smile. Because optimism is powerful. Okay, it can change your mindset and your outlook in life. And stress, lower your stress level. So keep smiling, seriously. Often when I'm bathing, I'm smiling at myself. Not like in a narcissistic way, but I'm telling myself, hey, be happy, it's a new day, you know? Like, there's so much opportunities and things that you could do. Upgrade your skills, meet new people, perhaps. Eat great food, I guess. Hopefully healthy food. Exercise. So many things you could do. So, explore new places, so travel. Like recently, you know, people, a lot of them went to Thailand, Songkram. Music so much better when you. Key so high now. I smile. Been here for a while. I smile. Don't give up now. When you smile, so smile. Dallas, New Orleans, Cleveland, Detroit, Philly, and Jersey, LA, Hello to my LA friends. Been there once, a little bit. Love the Californian vibe. Love Irvine, love Las Vegas as well. Went to Las Vegas, very cool place. It's true, what goes there, what happens there, stays there. A lot of crazy things happen to me there. So smile. Oh, interesting. This song followed by the song before. This song is literally called Daijoubu desu ka? Which means, like, are you okay? Are you fine? Are you alright? Because desu ka, it's like a question. You say Daijoubu desu ne? Daijoubu desu. I am okay, like, okay, like, affirmative. This is by Darren Ashley from Malaysia. Dun, dun. Reminds me of Wang Li Hong's song. There's some song that sounds like this. Alright, 10 more minutes. 10 more minutes left, and I'm done for tonight. Let's go, let's go. We can do it, we can do it. 大丈夫, 大丈夫. お疲れ様。 So far, 135 beats per minute, so great. I'm reaching there. My heart rate is consistently at my recommended or more, which is 120 to 130 for my height and weight and age, I guess. Thank you for everyone who's viewing, likes, comment, and love. Thanks for the encouragement. Arigato gozaimasu. Kamsahamnida. Open cup. Selamat. Sisie. Dote. Gamsia. Miki Nandri. Merci beaucoup. Obrigada. Grazie. Muchas gracias. Merci beaucoup. Let's go! Hyper potion! Okay, this is the fast one, I remember. Checkpoint! Nitro fun and hyper potion. 7 more minutes. Probably 2 more songs. This and 1 more, I guess. Let's go! Let's go! Let's go! Let's go! Imagine like you're traveling down, riding down a sunset, maybe to the beach, maybe in the desert. Woo. Cycling, cycling, tempo fast. Kampadai, kampadai. Let's go, let's go. Come with me, come with me. Woo, woo, woo. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Woo, woo, woo. I think like my own sounds into the song. Yeah, yeah. Let's go, let's go. Don't give up. Keep going. You can do it. Kampade, kampade. Kampade, kampade. Otsukare. Otsukare sama. Yeah, yeah. Daijoubu, daijoubu. Daijoubu, daijoubu. Let's go. Fighting, fighting, fighting. Do you like this fighting? Oh, oh, oh. Tempo going up, I guess. Let's go. Woo. Yeah. Let's go, let's go. 5 more minutes left. Woo. 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 18 to 19 kilometers per hour. That's good. Day 88. 29,000 553 calories burnt, 927 kilometers travel. Yeah. Woo. Then after tomorrow, I will reach 1,000 kilometers. Probably will burn 30,000 calories so far. Yeah. Break it down. Slow and easy. Chill. Cool down a while. Catch your breath. 大丈夫ですか? 大丈夫です? Awesome. Chill the time. Slow down. 4 more minutes. Heart rate 150. 150. I think that's the highest so far for the past few days. Wearing this watch. Okay. Can it be numb? The pulling is really straining my right arm because the resistance band is so tough now. Okay. Thank you, Tsune, the 20-something-year-old from Vietnam. He made it big. US Records actually signed him up. So good for him, and I'm supporting him. Ken Kitsune, T-N-K-I-T-S-U-N-E. This song, Bubblegum Popcorn. Not the best thing. It's all sweet and artificial flavoring. I do have popcorn. Yeah, I can make popcorn today, forgot. I still have one pack of popcorn, corn kernel, to pop. And I can add any kind of flavor I want. Cinnamon, chocolate, butter. Yeah. Let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go. And maybe tomorrow I'll cook some popcorn as a like a side dish with my remaining of what I cooked today. The sawarat laksa stew. I put rice and steak inside it. You know, there's tofu, minced beef, fish or sardine. I did put sardines inside. Yeah, I finished that one can of sardine left. I still have beans. So I'm still thinking, should I use the bean? Because the canned beans do have preservative and ketchup and lots of sugar actually. Yeah, I think I'll leave it to my housemate to eat. Better not eat canned food. Like I said, I'm still in progress of getting healthier in my diet, removing all the canned food where possible. You know, eat healthy by eating fresh, eating clean ingredients, and cooking it myself. I've been cooking and eating indoors for 88 days. Seriously, I have not eaten outside food at all. So, it does take a lot of willpower, so to speak. Many times when I go out, you may say, oh, this food looks nice, looks interesting. But then I think about the health aspects of it, the kind of ingredients that may go inside. Nah, no thanks. Oh yeah, let's pump out. Sorry, I went slow after just now that song. This one actually should be quite relatively fast. 2 more minutes. And I'm done for tonight, or 50 minutes of woohoo, full exercise. Let's go, baby. If someday I'm more well off financially and can travel, I want to go to Vietnam, go and find this guy, Ken Kitsune. Thank him for the kind of music. And you know, the music has so much energy, joy de vivre, you know. Like so much joy in life, and helps me in the workout, as a workout music. It's so fun, right? So check out all these artists, support them. You know, they do need your support. They take time to create all this music. And sometimes it does take genius to create some melodies, which is amazing. 1 more minute, the end of this song, and I'm done, I guess. Ba 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 ba. Let's go, let's go. These few days I'm trying to sleep early. Yesterday I slept at like 11:30-ish, almost 12. That's considered early for me. But I should go even early last year, sleep by 11 to sleep and wake up at 6 plus. You know, start the day fresh and good. Okay, we are done. Just nice, perfect. 9:35, 50 minutes. I'm done for tonight. So, thank you so much for viewing, and whoever, and to all who supported me Yes, Gampada, I know. I want you guys also to keep it up. And as usual, sorry. Eat well, sleep well, stress-free, you know. Be active, okay? Track your progress, all right? And like I said, don't give up, don't give up. Anything you start, please start doing and start soon and be consistent, all right? So take care, guys. Good night. Oyasuminasai. Annyeonghaseyo. Selamat malam. 晚安。再见。Bye bye.